The temporomandibular joint, TMJ, is formed by the articulation of the mandible and the temporal bone of the cranium. It is located anteriorly to the tragus of the ear, on the lateral aspect of the face. Articulating surfaces. The temporomandibular joint consists of articulations between three surfaces. The mandibular fossa and articular tubercle, from the squamous part of the temporal bone, and the head of mandibular condyle. This joint has a unique mechanism. The articular surfaces of the bones never come into contact with each other, they are separated by an articular disc. The presence of such a disc splits the joint into two synovial joint cavities, upper and lower compartments. Each lined by a synovial membrane and contains synovial fluid. The articular surface of the bones are covered by fibrocartilage, not hyaline cartilage. The articular disc is avascular and not innervated. The disc is attached to the condyle medially and laterally by the collateral ligaments. The anterior disc attaches to the joint capsule and the superior head of the lateral pterygoid muscle. The posterior portion attaches to the retrodiscal tissue in mandibular fossa. Retrodiscal tissue, unlike the disc itself, the retrodiscal tissue is vascular and highly innervated. As a result, the retrodiscal tissue is often a major contributor to the pain of temporomandibular disorder, TMD, particularly when there is inflammation or compression within the joint. Ligaments. There are three extracapsular ligaments. They act to stabilize the temporomandibular joint. Lateral ligament runs from the beginning of the articular tubule to the mandibular neck. It is a thickening of the joint capsule and acts to prevent posterior dislocation of the joint. Sphenomandibular ligament originates from the sphenoid spine and attaches to the mandible. It limits distension of the mandible in an inferior direction. Stylomandibular ligament, a thickening of the fascia of the parotid gland. Along with the facial muscles, it supports the weight of the jaw and limits mandibular movements, such as preventing excessive opening. TMJ disorders includes myofascial pain dysfunction syndrome, internal derangement, degenerative diseases, other disorders, ankylosis, dislocation and fracture. Myofascial pain syndrome. It is a chronic pain disorder. In this condition, pressure on sensitive points in your muscles, trigger points, causes pain in the muscle and sometimes in seemingly unrelated parts of your body. This is called referred pain. Symptoms: deep, aching pain in a muscle. Pain that persists or worsens. Difficulty sleeping due to pain. Risk factors: muscle injury, stress and anxiety. Treatment: pain relievers and muscle relaxants, antidepressants, sedatives, physiotherapy, massage, exercises and heat. Before explaining the difference between two types, the thing you should remember: in a normal joint, the thin intermediate zone of the disc is always interposed between the condyle and the temporal bone during all phases of opening and closing. This is to protect the articular surfaces when the joint is in function. The constant contact of the condyle with the intermediate zone, there will be no friction between the condyle and the articular fossa. In anterior displacement, the disc is positioned anterior and medial to the condyle in closed mouth position. In anterior displacement with reduction, we can see the disc is placed anterior to the condyle in closed mandible. During opening, the condylar head make friction with the disc while the retrodiscal tissue pulling the disc slightly backward to normal position. This friction caused the clicking sound. So this type of displacement called with reduction because the disc restored to its normal position in opening mandible. There is no limited mouth opening in this type of displacement. In anterior displacement without reduction, the disc placed anterior to the condyle head enclosed mandible. During opening, the disc interfere with the condyle and cannot return to normal position. So the mandible cannot open the full range, causing limited mouth opening without clicking sound. So the difference between two types, with reduction characterized by clicking sound during opening. Without reduction characterized by limited mouth opening. Degenerative diseases. The most common diseases which can affect TMJ are osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis. Rheumatoid arthritis is an inflammatory autoimmune condition that occurs when your body's immune system mistakenly attacks its own cells. RA commonly affects joints throughout the body, including the jaw. Rheumatoid arthritis causes inflammation, which leads to redness, swelling, pain, warmth, and stiffness in the affected joints. Osteoarthritis is a common form of degenerative arthritis, which can affect any joint in your body. It's associated with joint overuse, and it becomes more common as you age. Osteoarthritis of the jaw is characterized by the destruction of the hard and soft tissues around the jaw joints. This can change the shape and functioning of the jaw. Jaw damage may be on one or both sides. Symptoms includes pain, swelling, and stiffness in joints lasting more than 6 weeks. Restricted joint movement or locking of jaw. Other TMJ disorders are disc dislocation, which is complete dislocation of the disc from the joint. During opening, the disc become placed anterior to temporal eminence and cannot return to its normal position. In this case, the mandible should reduce to normal position by manual jaw reduction. TMJ ankylosis. It is fusion between the condylar head and the mandibular fossa cause deviation of the mandible to the affected area. This case needs surgical intervention. TMJ fracture usually occurs due to accidents, fall or violence. The treatment may be conservative or surgical in case of displacement of the fracture which needs reduction and fixation. Treatment options of TMJ disorders includes conservative management or surgical intervention. Conservative management options includes splinting by using soft acrylic splints to prevent parafunctional habits or bruxism, which may be the cause of the TMJ disorder. Physiotherapy includes therapeutic exercises, joint mobilization of the TMJ and cervical spine, active jaw exercises and strengthening, cognitive behavioral therapy. NSAIDs, analgesics and muscle relaxants to reduce pain. Arthrocentesis, it is also called joint aspiration, a procedure in which a needle is used to take fluid out of a joint to remove harmful bodies and substances. Joint injection of substances such as corticosteroids or Botox to reduce TMJ pain. Another type of injection called prolotherapy, which means injection of irritant substances such as dextrose solution. This causes fibrosis of the capsular ligaments and restrict movement of the joint. It is effective in treatment of TMJ dislocation. Arthroscopy, it is a procedure for diagnosing and treating joint problems. A narrow tube attached to a fiber optic video camera is inserted through a small incision. This helps visualization and treating the problem. Surgical intervention includes disc reconstruction. It is a procedure of discectomy in order to reposition the disc in its normal position. Indicated in disc displacement. Costal chondral graft, a surgical procedure in which a costal chondral graft is taken from the ribs. Indicated in case of damaged joint or TMJ ankylosis. Partial joint reconstruction. Total joint replacement. Surgical procedure used to replace the TMJ joint by artificial joint.